with a dream, my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame, excess. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy. Everybody seems so famous. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio. And a Jay-Z song was on. And a Jay-Z song was on. And a Jay-Z song was on. So I put my hands up to play my song. The butterflies fly away. Nodding my head like yeah. Moving my hips like yeah. Got my hands up to play my song. You know I'm gonna be okay. Yeah. It's a party in the USA. Yeah. It's a party in the USA. Get to the club in my taxi cab. Everybody's looking at me now. Like, who's that chick that's rocking kicks? She gotta be from out of town. So hard with my girls not around me. It's definitely not a Nashville party. Cause all I see are stilettos. I guess I never got the memo. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the DJ dropped my favorite tune. And the Britney song was on. And the Britney song was on. And the Britney.
Think of that comes to mind is the first time I actually had a real performance with the marching band, and I would say it would be our first time playing halftime at the football game when I was a freshman, because that, like, I was gonna quit before we did that performance because I thought it sucked. And then as soon as you get under those lights and you see all the fans and everything, it was just like, I don't think I'll ever have an experience like that again, to be honest.
Playing for the baseball team all 4 years, I've just had such a good time making so many memories with all my friends, getting closer with all the guys, and it's something I'll remember forever.
Football games, crosstown, showdown.
PH and Northern football games.
Playing in the Northern football game.
When we played Northern.
When we played Northern in the playoff game and we beat them.
Winning the chip back at Memorial against Northern.
Going to, like, the football games.
But I like going to the football games, like the away games.
Watching our football team win the PH Northern football game.
Football games.
Football games.
Northern game.
All the football games.
The past two football seasons, we won district championships back-to-back.
It's got to be in a ceramics class. One of my buddies got hit in the head with the rolling pin because one of our friends was trying to, like, golf with it, and he dropped it and bumped him in the head.
So, carry on to that story, same thing, it's probably one of my favorite ones too. And the kid who got hit in the head, he wanted us, like, he gave us his password to his phone, his dad's phone number. He thought he was gonna die, so it was kind of funny.
probably just be for soccer, just like the bus rides, the games and everything, because like that's just a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
My favorite memory would probably just be sports in general and marching band.
Freshman year volleyball. Didn't really know anybody, so it was like new and just new experiences, fun times.
I've gotten to do performing arts for all 4 years, and it has just been a lot of fun to do super crazy things with people that I didn't know at the beginning of each year.
Being in choir, you know, you get to sing in front of people, and singing in front of people is fun, you know. It's just a good time.
Just be with all these super cool teachers who I could pay attention slightly in their class and get good grades, and sometimes watch some Shrek.
Probably my entire junior year. Probably playing basketball that year.
The swim team, it was really fun having both Northern and PH together. It was definitely quite an experience.
Definitely volleyball season, and I liked the dances too. Those are my top two faves.
Definitely swim season, all 4 years.
Last year when we were district champs for the football team.
Honestly, that sounded like a buzzer for a football game.
Probably freshman year, the pep rally for the Northern game, because we had all of the like people that my sister grew up with, so I grew up with them, and it was probably one of just the greatest moments because everybody looked like they were together at once.
My favorite memory from high school would probably be just growing up with the girls that I've been playing soccer with since I was little.
Being able to play sports and find some passions with stuff that I do, like running and hockey. And I've also been able to participate in the guitar class here, which has also been a really fun memory for me.
This year, senior year, for the swim team, when we won the dual meet divisions, probably.
My freshman year, when I did the Canadian parade for the BRMM, and it was one of the most fun experiences I've ever had, because there were so many people there, there's so many people cheering us on.
It was me, Tyler, and Dylan, and in chemistry we had Mr. Moore, and I was like, it was like a crucible, like, and me and Tyler was messing with it, and I threw it to him, and he just looked at it, and it dropped, and it just smashed, and the whole class got quiet.
We had some random kid just come in our class, and he pulled the emergency water, and the whole class just, I don't know.
My first high school hockey game goal.
Big red wave, because I've been waiting for the senior big red wave, like, ever. So walking in and being there and being able to put my hand on the wall, that would be like my favorite memory forever.
Freshman year, when we were, I think it was like the rivalry game day, and we all like rode around in the back of Sophie Troy's truck, and we just drove around town. I think we did like the parade, and then we went to the game later that night, but I thought that was super fun.
Sophomore homecoming, because it was really fun, and then at the end of the day, I broke my foot, so. But it was a good memory, so.
Yeah, the whole summer.
The whole summer.
The
that
whole
year.
2019 summer was probably my favorite summer. Part of high school, yeah. With all our senior friends and our friends that everybody was close.
Mm-hmm. But can you put this in there? Just so people remember what I look like.
Just going to all the dances with friends and just having a good time with our classmates.
Things from like sports, like volleyball season, and then football season, like that time of year, and then homecoming and stuff like that is my favorite memories.
During orientation of senior year, when we got to put our handprints on the wall, I remember being really proud of that. Like, I'm finally here, I'm finally in my senior year, and that means a lot to me.
Probably just going to parties. That's about it.
All the friends and all the teachers.
Like the football games, but like specifically dressing up for them. Like I can remember, I want to think the theme was like beach themed or something, and me and Ari probably spent 3 hours like looking for Hawaiian shirts.
I remember that.
Sophomore year homecoming, because I loved my dress that year.
I'd say like 10th grade is the best year, just because, I don't know, we just, we were young and just did whatever.
Probably helping out at the field days for the younger kids. And I like a lot of the class assemblies too.
My favorite memory for sure has been my internship I got to do this year at a pediatric office. It helped me really decide on what I want to do with my life.
I don't think I could choose just one. I just feel like meeting new people in classes was definitely my favorite part, and just all the memories I made with them.
I came to dance, 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 dance. I hit the floor cause that's my plans, 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 plans. I'm wearing all my favorite brands, 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 brands. Give me some space for both my hands, 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 hands. You, you, cause it goes on and on and on. Came to move, 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 move. Get out the way of me and my crew, 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 crew. I'm in the club, so I'm gonna do, 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 do. Just what the fuck came here to do, 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 do. Yep, yep, cause it goes on and on and on.
Plan is going to Western Michigan University and becoming a chemical engineer.
I plan on just working right now in the trades. I already have a job set up because I did the construction program through Tech.
It's either attend Lawrence Tech, play basketball and become an electrical engineer, or Madonna to play lacrosse and become a nurse.
I am committed to SC4 for soccer. Unsure of what I'm going to go to school for because I don't know what I want to be yet, but I'm going to go there for 2 years and play soccer and then probably transfer to Grand Valley after that.
My plans after high school are to go to Lawrence Tech and play softball, and then I'm going to study forensic accounting.
I'm going to be going to Central Michigan University, and my roommate is my sister. I'm really excited about that. I'm going into secondary education, and I'm planning on hopefully becoming an ELA teacher
take some classes at SC4 and then transfer to Ferris State for criminal justice and eventually become a criminal justice lawyer.
I go to middle college right now at SC4, so after I graduate from here, I'll probably spend at least another year there to finish up my associates in general and science.
I'm planning on working straight out of it. Hopefully I can start working with my brother at ZF and then work up from there.
Probably my biggest one is probably I'm just going to go work in the trades, go probably plumbing, HVACs, something like that. So I've always wanted to do.
I'll be attending Michigan State University and I'll be majoring in kinesiology in the hopes of one day becoming a physical therapist.
I'm going to Ferris State and I'm in the pre-law program and I'm majoring in political science and double minoring in Spanish and international studies, and then after that I'll go to law school.
I'm currently enlisted in the National Guard through the Army, so July 6th I'll leave for basic training. And I'll be gone for about like 7 months because I'll go to basic training and AIT right after, and they're in the same place.
I am going to Northwood University to play basketball, and I'm going to go into healthcare management.
I'm going to Wayne State, and I'm majoring in digital design.
I'm going to Central Michigan, and I'm majoring in neuroscience.
I'm currently in SC4 for my prereqs, so I can take the RN program next year.
Right now I'm at SC4 getting my associate's degree, and then I want to transfer to U of M for pre-med and go from there.
I'm going to SC4 and I want to be a nurse.
And I am going to Indiana Wesleyan University to study nursing as well.
I leave August 30th for boot camp in the Marine Corps. I will be going as an electrician. I'm also going to be leaving with my brother as well. So,
I'm going to Saginaw Valley State University, and I'm going in for pre-nursing. Hopefully I'll get into their nursing program, and then from there I want to come back here to Port Huron and be a pediatric nurse up at the hospital.
I plan on attending SC4. I'm going to be playing soccer for them. I'm going to be taking the business transfer program, and I'm going to major in business management, minor in hospitality, and I plan to be an entrepreneur.
My plans after going to SC4 for business, then from there on, just go from there.
Either go to college or go find a job somewhere.
I'm going to do the same as Willie, go to SC4 to see if I'm interested in college and then transfer somewhere else.
I know I want to major in psychology, and I want to be a clinical psychologist.
I'm gonna go to a four-year university, and I'm going to get my bachelor's degree in chemical engineering, I'm thinking, and I'm guessing like I might minor in computer science.
Gonna be leaving for the Marines. My current contract has me set up for 6 years reserves, 2 years active, so in those 6 years I wanna come home, go to college, maybe go to Western or Kettering for a while, get an engineering degree, and then maybe transfer to a different college and get one in political science.
I'm going to SC4 for majoring in psychology, and I'm also thinking about nursing.
My plan so far is to just go to SC4 and just get my prereqs, and then hopefully after that I can transfer to maybe Oakland Community College and basically just become a dental hygienist.
I'm going to Saginaw Valley to get my degree in criminal justice.
I'm going to the Travel Academy to become an air flight attendant.
I'm still indecisive. I want to either go to be an attorney or I just started my own small business, so hopefully I can just do that.
I plan to go to Grand Valley State University to become a mechanical engineer.
My plan is to go to SC4 and get a business degree and then maybe transfer to a different school.
I'm going to Siena Heights University to play football and also get an education.
I'll be attending Concordia Ann Arbor. I'll be playing football there, and I'll also be studying psychologist. And after I graduate college, I would like to become a psychologist.
I'm going to go and play hockey at some school, and then I'm going to major in business and become a businessman.
I'll be attending Grand Valley State University, and I'll be playing football in the fall, and I'm going to be majoring in exercise science, hopefully become a chiropractor one day.
I plan on going to Siena Heights and playing football.
I plan on going to Arizona Christian University to play football and probably major in trying to be a physician assistant.
I'm planning on doing college and the Next Step program.
I'm going to finish up my degree in business. So after that, I'm going to do an apprenticeship to be an electrician. And then hopefully with my business degree, I can start my own business.
After this year, I have to finish out my 13th year with SC4. And then after that, I'd like to transfer to Michigan State or somewhere and maybe get a degree in political science.
I'm attending Hillsdale College's business program, but my plan before I like settle down and go into like the business field, I'd like to pursue like some jobs dancing and performing.
I'm going to Grand Valley and I'm majoring in exercise science. And then after I get my degree, I'm hoping to be an occupational therapist.
I'm also going to Grand Valley, but I'm majoring in education so I can go be an elementary teacher.
I'll be attending MSU. I'm not entirely decided on a major yet, but I'm thinking of pursuing pre-law, and I'm just excited to really have the college experience.
I'm going to go to Saginaw Valley to get my bachelor's in nursing.
I'll be going to Michigan State University to pursue a degree in kinesiology, and eventually I'll be going to grad school to pursue a degree in physical therapy.
I want to attend either MSU or U of M to go to school for computer engineering. My main goal is just to make a lot of money.
I am going to Central Michigan University, and I want to go into the psychology program. I want to get my master's in psychology.
I am going to Michigan State, and I'm going for nursing.
I'm going to go to Albion College and then study in kinesiology to become an athletic trainer. And hopefully my dream job is to come back and be the athletic trainer here.
Grand Valley State University, and I'm going to major in social work. I want to do that because I want to become a counselor or a therapist of some sort.
I plan on attending SC4 for the fall and winter semesters, and then the year after that I'll be going to Western Michigan University so I can study music production and communications.
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down a road and back again. Your heart is true, you're a pal and a confidant. I'm not ashamed to say, I hope it always will stay this way. My hat is off, won't you stand up and take a bow?
Thank you. enjoy everything that we had and slow down time. Don't rush the 4 years because it goes by so fast. So just enjoy every little activity and event we had to have.
After hard work comes success.
To not slack off and procrastinate and push things off.
Build up a better GPA. Not that like my grades are horrible, but if I could have like had the opportunity to build them up really early on, I feel like it would have made it a lot easier.
To stay away from the older girls, the senior girls, and then just to stay more committed and more focused in my earlier classes for my freshman year.
To be more focused and keep up on your grades.
A lot of the stuff you're gonna stress about is really pointless. It's better to keep a positive mindset and to take things as they are than to let your problems swallow you.
Not to stress about relationships, about boys, because it's only high school and you have your whole life.
Enjoy it while it lasts, because you won't get it again.
To get involved in everything, like sports, activities.
To keep your friend group small. Don't try to make it so big and to be friends with everybody.
Working on time management and preparing yourself for like tests and different things better. Coming up with a routine.
Not to be so serious all the time. To actually just let yourself be and actually enjoy your time while it lasts.
I would tell myself to just like live in the moment, because I think I spent most of high school going from one thing to another and like just constantly being busy and not actually enjoying myself.
Freshman, sophomore year were the times to be able to do the most things normally, so just be more involved. You'll regret it later on if you don't, because then it goes by so fast.
Get your stuff together, like stay organized and don't procrastinate.
I would tell my freshman self not to do a side part with her hair, because it just doesn't work for us.
I would say don't sweat the small stuff, I guess. I feel like when you're a freshman, you tend to think everything's so serious, and it's not.
Try to do your work more, definitely. Try to do everything. Try to just participate in everything, sports, extracurriculars, anything like that, dances.
Don't worry about what other people think about you, because you should do what makes you happy.
Get involved and just make the most out of your 4 years here, because they come and go like that.
Learn to close my mouth a little more. I think a lot of people would have appreciated that throughout high school if I would have stopped running it.
To be more confident in myself. To say it's okay not to fit in. You're okay as you are.
I would say like participate in stuff more, like sports and just like activities outside of school.
I'd say try out for new sports.
Probably just do better in my classes, not slack off as much.
Don't fail biology. first class I failed biology because I just didn't care in freshman year.
I would tell her that I know everything seems big and scary and new, but it's going to work out.
Try your best to get good grades, because your freshman year is the biggest year. Like it's the building blocks for your next 3 years.
Don't take your time for granted. I regret like not doing a lot of things I should have.
Take freshman year seriously. That's the year that actually really starts your GPA, and it's kind of hard to get it back up from that point.
Try out like new sports and, you know, work harder.
Actually do your work, be more mature and stuff, and just listen to the teachers.
Be a little bit more social, because you know, with these two, they're like one of my best friends now, and I didn't really start talking to them until like late sophomore year.
To never take online classes, because I won't do them until the last 2 weeks.
Actually pay attention during school and get things done on time.
Don't date a senior as a freshman or a sophomore. Bad idea.
Don't worry about the little stuff that happens, and like choose your friends wisely.
To still have fun, but to do your schoolwork.
The one thing I would take back is being rude to all of the teachers of my grades.
Make sure you stay caught up on your schoolwork and keep your circle small, because there's a lot of drama.
Be more involved with the school, do more things. Try not to worry too much, because you never know what could happen. You see how this year's going, so do it while you can.
I guess just not to stress about the small stuff.
Do your homework and stay away from girls.
I would tell myself to stop being so nervous about everything. And I would tell myself to open up more and stop being so scared of everything.
Cling on to people less and be more willing to let people go. You know, not every friendship is permanent.
Probably hang out with your friends like while you're still freshmen and still young, because like senior year and stuff, like we all have jobs, we're all so busy, you don't really get a lot of like time to see each other.
I would probably warn myself that my senior year was going to be like this, so I wasn't like disappointed.
Yeah, I'd probably tell myself not to worry about what other people think all the time, because I was always like worried that like, oh, they're going to judge me for this, they're gonna like, but nobody cares.
Walk with like confidence around, and don't be scared to like go up to people or do certain things. Just don't let yourself hold yourself back.
Be more social, because I was involved in sports, so I was social that way, but I wasn't really good at going up to people and talking to them. So I think that putting yourself out there is important, especially once you get a job, you're going to have to talk to people, so you might as well get used to it at a young age.
To live in the moment and to soak up all the memories, because high school really flies by and you don't realize that it's gone until it almost is.
To be just be like a little less nervous about my appearance, and just kind of go crazy and have fun with the people around here.
To stop procrastinating, because that's just a future Jeremiah problem and you have to do all that homework eventually, so just get it done now, you know?
Go to tech, because that just gives you a lot of good options and you can like get like Ford's like good connections with like future jobs and things. Although on the more social scale, I'd probably say stop being an idiot, because freshman me was a pretty big idiot.
When you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. The only way you can know, you give it all you had. And I hope that you don't suffer, but take the pain. Hope when the moment comes, you'll say, I lived. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. And when that sun goes down, hope you raise your cup. Oh, I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say, I lived.
come once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better.
Be the one that asks you about who your high school crush was.
I don't want to talk about it.
Love you, Joe. Can't even. Can't.
I don't really know what to say. Would come back to me?
Be honest.
Huh?
Be honest.
Oh, I'm not saying mine. I'm not doing this one.
Girl.
I'm not doing this.
For like how old she is, Jennifer Aniston,
Dylan Remblowski was my secret high school crush.
Yeah, I don't like anyone from this school.
Me neither. I, out of town.
This, if you were going to do a take right here, it might be like something emotional, like me looking out. After my last relationship, I haven't really just kind of like looked into dating anyone else, so.
My high school crush was Adrian Castillo, and he's my boyfriend now. So that worked out pretty well for me.
I got nothing. I don't like people.
It's going to cut to Ethan at the window saying, "I've lost all emotions."
Yeah, pass.
yeah, you wouldn't know him, you know.
I don't know if I'm gonna answer this one. Probably NA, I don't know.
Michael Post, we got together last year.
I can't answer that one. I didn't have any.
Your turn.
Should I say it? I don't know.
I think I'm gonna pass on that one.
I got this. I'm bold. We'll play the game. Johnny Henderson.
I mean, a girl can dream, but pass.
I didn't have one.
Neither did I.
The Northern girls, all of them, except the ones I'm related to, of course.
That would be my boyfriend of 5 years. he doesn't go to the school, but Michael Clore.
Everybody I ever had a crush on didn't go to the school. They always like lived out of state, so.
This one's easy. All my friends know it. Anyone who knows me knows it. Very simple, straightforward answer. I'm sure you guys can already guess it. Math. Math was my high school crush there. I came out and said it.
I think we're gonna go
I'm going to go with, I think Sophie Troy. I'm going to go with that.
No, I honestly don't think I have one.
I didn't have one either.
So I have a boyfriend of well over a year now. But when I was a freshman, I had a crush on Jace. That was a mistake. Fair warning.
My high school crush was probably Jocelyn Williams.
I don't know. I ain't really like that many girls through high school, so go ahead, Noah. Who was yours? I don't got one, bro.
What about
who?
One girl.
Who are you talking about, bro?
I don't know. All right, my high school crush was Vanessa Johnson, obviously.
So the first 2 years of high school, my crush, her name was Morgan James.
My freshman year, I didn't have a crush. And then my sophomore year, I started dating my girlfriend. So she's been my high school crush.
My high school crush was Jocelyn Williams. I dated her for 2 years, but yeah, that's about it.
I've had a few, but if I had to choose one, it would probably be Noah Kendall.
Probably Rob Miller.
Probably.
Can I say it on camera? Geeksy?
Well, to be honest with you, I don't think I really had one.
I think he's
these females
lying.
Don't really catch my eye.
I think he's lying, but
I'm being honest, bro.
It's okay.
Jocelyn Williams.
Oh, okay. That's a good answer. That's a good answer.
I can honestly say I definitely thought a lot of the boys here were pretty cute, but I truly did not have like a crush on anyone throughout the years. So.
Mine's obviously Noah Mant since seventh grade, because we've been dating since seventh grade.
Mr. Savidra, the teacher.
No comment.
My high school crush would probably have been my boyfriend, Richard Barnum.
My high school crush was Jace Mullins.
Freshman and sophomore year was Jocelyn, and then junior and senior year was Peyton.
Probably freshman and sophomore year, it was Frankie. And then 11th grade, this other girl that goes to Northern that I'm dating now.
Marysville.
Oh, Marysville, my bad, Marysville.
So only one, Miss Moran.
Oh, oh no. We're not gonna talk about that.
I don't know, like, I thought people were cute, but I never thought someone was cute all throughout high school, I guess. I don't know.
I never really had a high school crush. I like Lainey, I just think people are cute, but that's it.
Haley Baldock.
For me, it's probably a tie between Mrs. Moran and Mrs. Taddy.
My freshman year English teacher, Miss Bernardi. She doesn't teach her anymore, but.
Man, if you don't say your girlfriend,
no,
bro,
man.
Come on.
Wow. Oh. No, I'm
she
Miss
sees
Bernardi.
This, you're dead. You
Miss,
know that.
Miss Bernardi, I'm sorry.
Thinking about the fans, we were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young.
Told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you offer.
were still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. At night, worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. I wish somebody would have told me. Good old days, all the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May it take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we gonna have. You don't need money, got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all. Bracelet. May you keep the chaos and the clutter off your desk. May you have unquestionable health and less stress. Having no possessions, though immeasurable wealth. May you get a gold star on your next test. May your educated guesses always be correct. And may you win prizes shining like diamonds. May you really own it each moment to the next. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow. Oh. Well, here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. I want you to have it. Here's to the good times we're gonna have. You don't need money, got a free pass. Here's to the fact that I'd be sad without you. I want you to have it all.
If you believe it, then anything can happen. Go, 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 raise your glasses. Go, 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 you can have it all. I toast you. Here's to the hearts that you're gonna break. Here's to the lives that you're gonna change. Here's to the infinite possible ways to love you. You to have it all.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. I wish you love for you the world just opened.